Then after that, discussion of the market model. What is the market model? Because everything that you are doing, there is a theoretical explanation. That discussion must come first. After the discussion of the market model, you put down this printout. You put it exactly like this. And please do not copy and paste anything. Write whatever you want to do. This part should be in your own words. Then it's fine. Yes?
Yes.
This part should be in your own words. You should copy and paste this from Excel printout. And I will know the biggest mistake made here is some people, they don't take the share return, but they use the, they take this beta, not the share return, but they take the share price. I know straight away, I can't tell you how, but I know straight away that's wrong. Yeah? You must make sure it's the return of the share against return of the market, regression. Not just the share price against it. I've given you my, you know, you can practice. So the serious student will get very far ahead because he has followed every point. And I'm going to give you one day, you know, like one Friday, one day just to come and only one day. That's only one day to come and show you, just to browse through your okay tenders, yeah? So this is the how you will copy and paste the printout. After that, then next you've got discussion of the yield curve and its implications. 300, what is the yield curve? You know, well, I can explain to you. Somebody has the yield curve.
Yeah.
You look at the market, the return on zero coupon bonds. The definition of yield curve is the return on zero coupon bonds of different maturity over time. That's the definition of yield curve. What is the return on zero coupon bonds of different maturity over time? That's the yield curve. Now, you will find other definitions too, but that is the most basic one. Every bond which is zero coupon, whatever return is 1 year, 2 years, 20, up to 50 years, that is the yield curve. That gives you a unique interest rate for discounting over 50 years. Are we clear?
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad some of you are shaking your head. Others are just like keeping quiet. Yeah. Anyway, then you're going to discuss what is this market risk premium? What does that mean? What is the what are the extra return you are getting in the market over and above the risk-free rate? RM minus RF. Why you should invest in a share, which is a risky asset? You can simply put in the risk-free asset and get a return of RF. But if you invest in a risky asset, there is something called market risk premium, RM minus RF. Sometimes it is also called EMRF, EMRP. What is it? Equity market risk premium. Both are same. So you can do a research on the internet, research on the textbook, research on journal papers, and give your opinion what you expect the equity market risk premium to be for your own calculations, for your future. That is critical thinking. Are you understanding? Rather than, okay, for RM is 14 and RF is 6, so just take RM. That is for a calculation. But here you are thinking, what is it correct? What is it that is a correct one to use? So each one of you will have a different estimate. That's perfectly okay. Because you are using your judgment over the last 20 years, over the last 10 years, over this, over that. And you are giving some explanation of what the equity market risk premium is. Are we clear? So then we have, at the end you have valuation of your company. I've just taken it out of, you know, that method valuation example I gave you. And finally, you must critically discuss your results and make a recommendation of buy, hold, or sell. So the whole assignment looks like this. I don't know how to make this, how to make it, you know, flat.
100%.
Sorry?
100%.
Press?
Yeah, that should be 100%, 20%.
How to make it, you know, like all over the place.
Over there.
What?
You mean like a handout?
No, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, just spread across the page. Is it this?
You go on view over there.
Sorry.
View. Look at new view over there.
View. Aha. View. Then.
No, not yet. Not full screen.
Page display.
Why?
Right.
so two pages scrolling over.
How is it, John?
Which tells me?
Page display.
Two page scrolling. Two page scrolling, like.
Two page.
No, after that, two page scrolling, that's it, that's it.
Reduce it to 30%. We want more than two page scrolling, but this one just has two page scrolling, that's all, yeah? We want to show multiple pages. There's no point wasting all this because Bill Gates keep on changing every 3 years. Yeah. Okay. I don't have time. He keeps on changing his program. Yeah. So this is it. I know him. The whole of this computer industry, they came up in 1976. There was nothing there. Then all these people were just floating around in Texas with no job, wondering what to do. Yeah. You know the story of Bill Gates or not?
No.
Did I tell you? You want it? I don't want it now. Maybe later on. Before the end of the class. Yeah. Okay, because just to give you some inspiration. Okay, so this is the assignment format. Page one, introduction. Then discussion on the market model. Market model printout. Then here is the... the equity market yield curve, then the market risk premium, then the finding from the calculation. This can actually take another page. This doesn't show, this should be another page, yeah? It should be another page before that. View. Yeah, so you can take one page for full calculations, yeah, before you came to this discussion of market risk premium, then one page for calculations.
How we can make 600?
Yes.
Huh?
600 is too much. Words.
You write two pages for this, that's why I kept 600 words. So you show using the price, how you got the asset base, how you got the earnings base, then you summarize, end with a table like this. You end with the table, just
it's
like the example I gave you.
How I got all
of course, you just can't just say asset price plus the price is 250. What do you know? You have to show the calculations, my dear. This is a finance exercise.
But calculation doesn't mean that 600 words.
All the details, yeah, discuss it. 600 will be two pages.
400.
Two pages is allowed. Okay, look, this is not a bazaar, just do what you want. Okay, next part is that you go to critical evaluation where you compare the fundamental price you obtained with the fundamental price and then recommend buy, sell or hold. It's a discussion. Then after that, you must put your data, two things, bare data as well as return. So that then just look up to be safe with you, and the whole thing is coming to about 10 or 12 pages, that's all. So I will be there one day evening to see your, and this is the yield curve which I want to give you as of 1st October if you want. So that gives you all the interest rate, it is common for everybody. I have taken it out that September 29th is okay, yeah? So what is the 1 year you are interested in? 2 year you are interested in, 5 year, or you can read off the graph or whatever it is. For your discount rate.
So we can use 1 year now.
Huh? 1 year is for the first year of discount.
Yeah.
2 year is for the second year of discount. Like you know, it will be like KE, one plus KE square, one plus KE, one plus KE squared, one plus KE cubed. That will be according to 2 year, 5 year, 10 year and 30 year.
Pardon?
For first year you will use 0.59. No, first year you will use, 1 year, blue, the blue line, red is for US. You will use 0.59, means discounted by 1 plus 0.0059. So it's 0.59%.
That means it's 0.5%. 1.0059. Don't divide 1.59 and do funny things. Yeah? The same thing here will be 1.009. Then 1.0182. 1.0247, 1.0309. So like that, you normally you see after 10 years, the value becomes very less.
Why we are supposed to be paying for 10 years? Because we have to stay for a year.
Huh?
Why we are paying for 10 years? Because we are paying for a year.
Discounted cash flow, you think you do 1 year, you use the discounted cash flow of the cash? I don't know what analysis you are doing, Ramchandra, I am in shock. The cash flow is going forever, for perpetuity. You are supposed to discount every single cash flow. What I am saying is, usually beyond 20 years, the figure will be very low to save you some calculations. You are thinking you just discount by 1 year. I don't know what you are saying here. The cash flow goes for 20 years. Okay, let me tell you. The cash flow is 1 year cash flow, EPS, supposing it is something, free cash flow. Yes, free cash flow. Like that. So you will make the cash flow and then you will discount it by the appropriate for the appropriate period. Mm. Did you understand or not?
No.
Quick, I'm writing a pen here.
Where do we get the cash flow from? Do we need to get from the company financial cash flow?
Free cash flow, yeah. Let us go back to the other example we did about is the class. Let's look at this.
It's a bit confusing.
All learning is confusing, yeah? This is not rote. This is learning. You want everything very simple and all that. It's not like that. Please, let us do this question again.
Yes, sir.
Methods of valuing the stock of a company. Okay, valuation sample, sales was so much, profit after, please listen carefully, I'm explaining the question. Profit after tax was so much, share capital reserve was so much, depreciation was so much, net additional estimate for capital expenditure was so much, number of shares was so much, loans was so much, beta was 0.9. In this simple case, the yield curve is flat. But in reality, the yield curve is not flat. Okay? Then you are just going to take the interest rate for different period. Then the equity market risk premium is assumed to be 8%. That is also from your own research, not like this. Yeah? Because this is a textbook calculation, which is simple and happy for you. Yeah. Then the company has been declaring all its earnings as dividends. The share is now quoted at £4 on the market for small companies. Okay? So data, where is the biometric piece? I need to buy. There are people who are just floating around.
Yeah, we went to
Poker House. Yeah. No, you went to Poker House. Right. You like it? Okay, just please, quickly, just get the biometric back here.
Sure.
Anyway, yeah, please finish the biometric and bring it back here. Yeah. So, please, here we have got two tables, parameter, etc. Method for industry average. What did we do? Industry average, I took the earnings per share. I took the total profit after tax. You write down, please. I think I didn't realize you guys needed it. How will you calculate this price, profit after tax divided by number of shares, multiplied by the PE ratio.
This one here.
That's fine. For everybody. For everybody.
What is it, sir?
Please. Hold on. So, earnings base. That's why today we are only doing this, clearing up earnings base valuation.
Oh, okay.
Equal to profit after tax divided by number of shares, number of ordinary shares, yeah? Divided by, remove the preference shares, remove the